Hey guys, Stealth here. Time for a live gameplay, and this is a live gameplay on a map that you rarely, if ever, see. This is Smoke on the Water, and in case you haven't seen the map before, you got a large naval slash land spawn zone on Foxtrot. You have Alpha as a pure naval. You have Bravo as a, let's say, a neutral zone. It doesn't really give you anything but points. Golf gives you a ton of points but has no cover. Hotel, and then India as a mirror to Alpha on the other side. Delta starts there, sorry, Red starts on Delta and Charlie. Now considering that it's going to be very, very tough to get up to this island, I picked my Dutch deck, which I have in the air deploy mode. So my mode of deployment is everything goes in helicopters. UH-14s, AB-204s, and I have some of them in the standard autocannon wielding transports. Now, the guys seem to have filled a lot of ships, and I can't blame them, because we started out with 2,000 points. Now, I would like to capture Gulf, but capturing this with infantry is going to be freaking tough. There's no cover anywhere. If I can make it up there first, I at least have a decent chance, but the enemy might have the same idea. So instead, I'm going to go with a couple of cheetahs. I'm going to go with my entire ASW fleet, my anti-ship warfare units, because there are probably a lot of ships to be had. Now let's go with some Apaches, one there and one there. It is going to be a live gameplay, and that means that my gameplay itself might not be entirely up to par, because of course I'll be commenting and going through the gameplay itself at the same time. Alright, these aircraft all have the same speed. Let's make them into two teams, one, one, and one. That's team one, and these are team two. There. Now, if I can see any ship, I can fire 8 anti-ship missiles at them, or I can select both groups and deploy 16 anti-ship missiles. This is going to be a big, and I'm talking big, naval fight. A whole lot of Lafayettes, Bohangs, a ton of Perrys. And, ooh, we already got a large air patrol here. It's one of those 10v10s where you just have a lot of income. Bloody hell, would you look at that. Yaks, SU-27s, MiG-25s, this guy's going full air patrol. He has nothing other than those units. That is bad news for my Apaches, though. We do have someone going over to that flank. Now the important thing to remember about this map is that, for example, I cannot deploy a tank here. There is no way to get it across. And, oh crap, that's something I just realized now. That means that I'm limited, and I'm talking very, very limited, because I can only field my infantry. Let's start nailing some of these jets. One down. Two down. Anyone else want some? Yes? Okay. I can only field amphibious units and helicopters, because my naval units do not have a landing craft, which means I would normally just offload a landing craft and field a new one. That can't be done, though. Looks like these guys are taking... Holy hell. Apaches. This is going to be your fight. I want you over there and you over there. Now, with this constant air train, it is very, very difficult to actually do anything with my helicopters. Do anything remarkably or close to useful. Oh, there's another jet down. There's another one down. Two cheetahs, backed up with a couple of other support units, but really. Look at the Apaches go. I've barely fielded any units. I have 800 points in in the bank, ready to deploy. I'm really only waiting to make sure that we can actually penetrate. Oh, we already got this zone. Alright, team one, team two. We're gonna... Oh, shit, son. I completely ignored that I'm flying over a ton of AA there. Bloody hell, I just lost 4 aircraft. So that was a bit painful. Wonderful. And what do we have here? Looks like another bomber. No, it's a seed. It was a seed. Could you hover high for a change? It's not usually how I use my helos, but in this situation it's going to work out really well. Look at that, 760 points! I killed what, one ship? And a whole lot of aircraft? I should have deployed my tanks. Look at that, all these beauties. I have no way to deploy them now. Except there, but... who needs tanks over there? Of course, the enemy has the exact same problem. Up to the point where... oh, something just got nailed there. Up to the point where they might have resupply craft. They may have their version of the Muna. They may have units along the lines of the transport ships. Which means that they can actually get these guys across. Oh dear. Not a good zone to fly into. An Uloy and a Sovremeni. Because why not? I could send over some helos to help here, but I'm very nervous about them getting knocked down by all of these ships. What do we have here, though? One Uloy. I can dump 8 missiles onto this guy. Provided he's alone. He does seem to be alone. We already got one quitter, Coastal. The entire team of Red 4 is still here. Explosion in the ammo room. That Uloy is going down. Free to fire. Yeah, he's never going to survive all of these missiles. And there we go. Not my kill. What? We lost one? That was particularly lucky on their part. Over high. Now, my resupply is also partially airborne. Unfortunately, these guys are not capable of floating. What do I have this capable? Oh, I can get my HGM units across. That might be an interesting thought. Trying to get some HGMs across. First up, I'm going to get rid of those motos. And then we're going to go with an Apache escort. You're going to help out there. Oh, snap. I'm out of here. Good as Tunguskas are, sorry, as Apaches are, they are no match for a Tunguska. And a bunch of T-80s is also going to make my life very, very difficult. Especially the combination is the problem here. If those Rangers can knock down the Tunguska, which really won't be that easy, I can help out with my helos and get these guys nailed, especially the tanks. Sent my helo over. Seriously though, this is one of the weirdest maps that you can play. Because it is so... it's so unusual in the sense that you don't have any kind of land reinforcement for Echo or Charlie. So, either you deploy your tanks on the island, or you float them across. There is no middle ground. There's just no option. Massive amount of anti-ship missiles going in. It's another big explosion. Jiang Yu really panicked there. Start killing some five bows here. Come on. What's the range on those MLUs anyway? 7.5. They should be in range. Yak 141. Might be able to get that guy. Come on. Missiles going in. Hit. Missed. Ooh, got him. See ya. Ah, shit, he nailed him. I was hoping he'd survive. And here is the enemy air force. Albeit not too impressive. I think that the guy using all of those helicopters, sorry, using all of those jets is reconsidering his options. Thing is, I don't know about their AA here. If I'm running into a horde of AA, I'm going to be in a world of hurt. Let's go for a recon helo. I got plenty of those. One there, one there, one there. Oh, they captured it! Well done to you folks. Time to send in my own guys. Here come the Marine Corps. And let's go with some Stingers for good measure. Okay, those might be a bit more expensive, especially combined with the MLUs that I just purchased. Come on. You're hurt. Get back here. India is not theirs. They have two capital ships and it's not theirs. Ah, TACCOM. Well played. Because that does deprive them of a little... Wow, it's actually a little bit of income. It's not really that impressive. What do we have here? That looks like a jet. Yep, Yak-38. Way outside my range, though. Not a problem for Burak with four short arrows. Yeah, he's right. We do need recon, and it is coming in. Looks like we're about to push these guys off of Charlie, which means off of the island. Hello. There's a couple of books there. Unfortunately, the Dutch don't get a seed aircraft. Otherwise, I would be able to nail these guys and then fly in with my helos. No such option here. Here's the Marines. What do we have there? Are these still the tanks? Yep, definitely looks like it. Scratch one tank. What the hell hit them? Oh, an Apache joined it. Ah. Scratch all the tanks. Not bad. Oh, there's still something else there. Here the M3. And something that appears to be transports. Oh, actually. That's the T-80Bs. I thought these were dead. Offload, offload, and get out. And you can see the AB-204B lagging behind there. These things have to go. With an Igla group, that's going to be a pretty interesting feat. I mean, my helicopters are a no-go. Marine Corps have AT-4s. 19 armor penetration will do it. It's not too convincing, though. Gotta nail these Spetsnaz right now. You drop them off over there and pull back. Another Tarantula fleet coming in. Ooh, looks like they're already being worked up by these Perrys and this Hatsuyuki. Let's help them out a little bit. Because they're only firing one missile, and I can fire volume. We're engaged. Whoa! Second fleet. Yep, airstrike going in. Scratch one tarantula. Lost one Marine Corps group. Come on. There you go. Tanks are down. Anyone into soccer or football? Van Gaal, maybe? I had a guy, a Dutch guy, contact me the other day, which was about the Leopard 2A5 tactical video. And he said, oh my god, that was my name. I sent in my name, I had no idea it would ever get picked. But yeah, he was apparently one of the units that I was commanding. One of the Dutch units, that is. Good day, sir. Hill secure. Send in a cap here. Normally I don't use helicopter commands, but since this is a sort of semi-airborne deck, it is actually not a bad choice, especially for a map like this. Come on over. Oh, shit. That's a book. And then some. Uh-oh. Shit, Tunguska's gonna nail these helicopters. Are my mortars... Yeah, my mortars are amphibious. Okay. I could try rushing these guys down the hill. Jeez, there's absolutely no cover on this bloody volcano. Alright, let's get my AA back up. Up you go. There's a Vasilak mortar running away. He's not, or actually he's limping away. Damaged gearbox. Marines, your kill. It's gonna be an interesting play to see if I can nail these guys without taking too many losses. More missiles are going in. Sovremeni is just ignoring everything though. Kill order. There, AT4 down. Oh, hello. That's the Tungush. Jesus. If that thing fires, they just knock off 5 to 10 infantrymen instantly. Look at them go. That's ridiculous. Nash, I'm sorry to say, but that thing is going down. There. We're going to set up a resupply point for the Marines here, considering that they took a massive amount of losses there. Okay, moving up. Command helo has been secured. There's my escort, there's my TD tank killer. There's still something up there. We are slowly but steadily pushing them off of the island. Charlie's no longer theirs. A hotel is, though. Let's see, do we have enough AA here? We got a Crotal and a Gepard. Yeah, we should be fine. Some Avengers pushing up. Yep, we got this. Let's keep going. How are we doing on the ship front? Not too bad. Oh no, I'm not going to fly that engine again. That did not really work out last time. Not exactly. Pushing into Delta, though, that's going to be a whole different story. Airstrike group, get ready. It's a bit nasty, but I want to nail the Muna. If I can nail the Muna, I can blow up the ship next to it as well. And deprive them of about 16,000 points of supplies. Fly in, missiles out, and do not get hit, please. Boom. Splash. Oh, we captured a fob. Oh, and then some. We're gonna need a cheetah here. And I'm thinking that their AA is probably dead. Whoa! Loads of vehicles just came ashore here. Hordes of Motostrelki. I'm gonna need another Apache escort. Escort, over there, kill the Motos. 80 Motostrelkis? Are you kidding? Goodbye, Strela. Alright, resupply point in position. Escort! Rocket pods! 75, 75. Come on. There's a PU up there. Oh, PU just got nailed. Beautiful. Alright, let's fly in another command helicopter. Look at the air raid here. I'm considering sending up a couple of bake news. I got 13 elites. The problem is that these Jiang Yus and the Sovremenis are a huge threat, and they can and likely will kill any of my units there. Alright, move up. Use the fob for resupply. Second group is ready. We're not getting shot at here. Killed an Anushka 3. And his... no, his buddy's too far away. Never mind. One by one, then. Just lost my recon helo. Goodbye. I got a lot of aircraft overhead. Mother cheetah. All the way over there. Move up. Not silver many, though. It's just sitting there. Range on the silver many's missiles is about 9.5. Yeah, so from over here, he could still hit them. If I had a ship over there. Oh, you think that's a good idea? Let me inform you about the AA that I have here. I just cannot really get to the shoreline. Not that town, without risking a lot of forces. Come on! Shit. I just spotted the cheetah. This cheetah's down. Is cheetah amphibious? No, none of my support units are, save for the M106. Okay. In that case, we're gonna have to go with the standard AA infantry. They're gonna fly in from over there, that's fine. Two groups. Get up. I know you're rearming, but I need you airborne. I need you using those guns before they shoot some rocket pods into you. Marines! Anything you can do to help out? No? Okay. Hold. Range on their AA missiles against helicopters. 3.5. That's probably the bastard that killed my other recon helo. See if you can hit that Jangu 3 up front. They are currently too far apart to be spreading their AA around. Seed. Oh, Seed just nailed the rip here. Hit him. I think that the other guy has the same idea. Super Hornets coming in. Missiles out. Ah, they're getting too close. Just one hit then, yeah? Yeah, one hit. Sovereign's leaking. I am not sticking close to this shoreline. Way too dangerous. Let's move you up to the fob a little bit closer. Ah, good. The Marine Corps is ready. Zone captured, thanks to my CV there. Oh, the Dutch voice acting is so bad. So bad. Attack markers, ammo, please. I believe you have ammo, save for 3 missiles. And your Congo is good too. Unfortunately, I don't have any units that can help out. What? Just got attacked somewhere. Seed. Oh, shit, that's the last of my Spogs. So somebody likes to set the place on fire, apparently. What was that? Mars, MLRM. Yeah. Yeah, now you see we can't have that. Where are you coming in from? This angle, okay. I can just do a flyby with my anti-ship units. Use their AIM-9s. Kill the helos, whichever they are. And then, as a finishing touch, I can kill the Nanushka. You're good to go. Fly by. No hits. Exit pattern, Nanushka, missiles going in, Nanushka dead. Perfect. That's what I want to see here. Oh, we got a company. Stingers. I need you to get closer right now. We got 10 Gornos. On our shores. Split. Attack. Super Cobras. Didn't quite get them though. Yep, got one of them. You're still here, are you? Dutch Marines say leave. So you leave. There's the Sovereign Many. Okay. So what do we do now? Because we've taken control of the island. I'd say pretty completely. The thing is... Oh, ouch. So much for my AA. The thing is that now we need to start working our way over to Delta. That's not going to be easy. Since the only units that can go there are either helicopters or amphibious units. The second category I don't have. How many reds are left? 5 versus 8 blue. Look at this guy, Bibby95. Is that the guy using the arty? Yeah. He must be using something else as well. Is he killing ships or something? Because otherwise it's going to be really hard on a map like this to ramp up a score like that. Let's go with the recon helo here. Vlad surrenders. That's not their Vlad. Oh, sorry, that's not our Vlad. No, that's their Vlad. I think he realized that the game's pretty much up. But not quite. Because while we are in control of the island, if they just camp, they can really make life miserable for us as we are trying to land. We've got a very heavily damaged Udaloy here. See, at this point I'm getting worried about flying an aircraft. Because I don't know how fast their air response is going to be. Or let me rephrase that. I know that their air response is going to be instant. Big arty battery going for the ships. You may want to defend those. Where's that recon? Oh, there we go. LEVC-2 coming in to cap the position. Good. We need to get all of these helos away. Changyu range, 4,300 meters. Alright, at the risk of losing these aircraft, I need to get that Changyu away so I can nail the helicopters. On my way to coordinate. He seems to be alone. Now, this is not something I generally recommend, but automatic evac Winchester disengaged, so that now these aircraft will not automatically evac. I can tell them to fire and then go somewhere else, do something else, until I manually tell them to evac. So we can evac them over to the right position. Now I can evac them. Changyu's heavily hurt but not killed. And all of my aircraft are safe. I just did that to make sure that they were not going to fly over all of these ships. If those units would fly over Sovereign Many, there would be a lot of pain going around. Sour Apple and Z surrenders. We just got one guy left. Yeah, we got this. Oh dear, what are you firing at? Canadian Airborne, probably. Stop complaining. Super Cobras are going for what? 2 transports? It's a bit of an overkill for 2 MTLBVs, wouldn't you say? Look at that! Okay. Now, considering that his entire team left, he has an incredible availability of his units. Really, really high availability. So, we could be seeing some really weird attack waves come in. Wow, you just wiped out your own infantry, didn't you? Shit. Attacking is a big no-no. Way too dangerous. Do not move your Changyu away. Shit. If he runs, I won't be able to get him. What is this? Oh dear. That's a recipe for disaster. Lost my Marine Corps there. gotta get this guy before he makes his escape and gets under the AA umbrella of the Sovereign Many there. Okay, we're gonna kill the Moon instead. Kill. Once fired, evac. Or actually... yes! Got him. And the ship next to it as well. Oh, this one got hurt. Pretty bad. Look at that, we're just flying in. Interesting. They may not have any AA here. What is that exactly? Must have been some stray missile. This, if it happens, is going to be a very, very uneven fight. Because we're going to be fielding infantry, and they're going to be fielding tanks. We field helicopters to kill the tanks. They field the Tunguskas and whatever else the hell they can throw at us. I thought you guys were gone. I guess not. Okay, get to a fob. That CF-18 is lucky to make it out alive. Super Cobras will eat up this MI-1. Easy. Personally, I would not do that with the missile. I'd just, yeah, go with the Vulcan. Oh, DAPS has different. Okay. Fair enough. Now, the way that I look at these ships is like an onion. If you want to kill these things, you're going to have to peel back layer after layer after layer. So we're first going to have to take out the Sovereign Many, then possibly a Hujan, then possibly the next, then the Udaloy, and then... and so forth. It's going to take a lot of time. And it's not time that I don't have, it's just time I don't want to spend. God, this is going to cost us a ton of points! This is a big suicide rush. Those missiles have, what, 8 HE? One missile's gonna kill two helos. Just for the sheer splash effect of it. Here comes the Air Force. That's less than I'd expected. Looks like the Super Cobras are retaliating. But they just spent everything and they are no longer returning fire. Here's my little attack group. Oh, anti-ship battery. Pretty expensive at that, too. Oh, never mind. I was thinking this was one of those 80-point batteries. The ship just blew up there. Go. I wouldn't be surprised if there are two, possibly three CVs in a position like this. That's a command helo, that's for sure. Shit. As expected, Tunguskas. Hello. Please kill that CV and hope that we get this thing over and done with. We lost it. It's not dead for sure. Range, 6.5 kilometers. There's the CV, guys. That's an MI-4 command vehicle. And that's a triple Berusa threat. Haha. No thanks. See, I'm just not as aggressive as Ernst there. Just, I'm not gonna fly in with a bunch of helos and hope for the best. Not against three Berusas. Which are getting pretty heavily trained. Through the sheer destruction. Oh, by the way, I just said that if we kill the CV, we get the game. It's not technically true, is it? Not with all of these ships nearby. That's going to be a very big issue. We can, however, try to capture this zone. Yes, let's capture the zone and then punch these ships with anti-ship missiles and tanks. Because if we capture this, I can finally field my tanks. But we won't actually be capturing it, we'll be neutralizing it. If we want to capture it, we're going to have to push out all of these Jangyus. That's going to take a long time. It's not impossible, it's just going to take about, I don't know, 26 minutes maybe. I'm hoping that those Super Hornets are going to strike the Sovereign Many. They won't be able to kill it, but they will be able to panic it. Possibly knock out the radar. That'd be wonderful. Yep, he's pretty much down. Tram Intruder comes in. These things are terrible, by the way. Because by the time that you are firing all of those missiles, you're likely to get shot at yourself. Alright, missiles in. Evacuating the planes. Hu Jian is not dead. These things are just too lucky. Buster, with all of his infantry, is going to find the CV. Provided that it is ashore. Oh, nice kill. Comes another helicopter attack wave. Two tram intruders firing 8 missiles. They're going for the Udaloy, not even for the Muna. Whoa, look at the AA battery here. Alright, all of you, get over there and land. And then pick up the Marines. Make sure all the Marines are ready to go. Get the Stingers with. Here comes the CV. There. That will at least knock out all of their air support. Look at the artillery run. 8 MSTAs. That's... wow. It's almost 1,000 points in artillery over there. Killed. ASM threats, back up. They're coming in from the south this time. Udaloys are such incredibly difficult ships to kill. Exceptional Sea Whiz. Yep, zone neutralized. No more air support or ground support units for you. They cannot call in anything. It's now about dismantling this group. Come on in. Hit the Udaloy. And then get out. No, not that way! Oh dear. Wow, that was lucky, that was. And so is that, by the way. Those aircraft really should not have made it out alive. Alright, you guys refueled? Where's the next group? I thought I had multiple of these UH-14s. Where's the rest of them? Or am I looking for these? No. These are Lynx helicopters. Alright. So we're gonna have to make you into groups of 2 again. You take that flight, you take the other one. I gotta say, for a deck that's really only able to field helicopters and infantry, and a couple of anti-ship planes, I'm not doing too bad at 2,500 points. Looks like the Udaloy is dead. That's not the way to use a Harrier. Really. Oh no. The one thing that might be helping is that these guys are almost out of anti-air missiles. Especially those HQ-7s should be almost depleted, but they have the same range. Oh dear, look at this. This is going to be one big death trap. I'm really waiting for a missile to come in. Yep, another helo down. And yes, they did kill ships, but now the Cobras are out of missiles. They're going to rush in. They're going to get themselves killed. And that right there is about another 100 and... well, I'll say 240 points. These things are 60 points, yeah? Yeah. The AH-1Fs are slightly more expensive. They're also pushing in. They're just gifting this guy points. He is feeding like crazy. I mean, I've been known to do that, but not like that. Fly in there, move there, offload, and fly away. They have another CV. They have another ground-based CV. Otherwise, considering all of these ships are moving, otherwise we would have halved them by now. So, we're going to send in the Marines and try to find that thing. That's your target. Yes, we got it. Tanks. Tanks, tanks, tanks. More tanks. Not sure if we can even get in range like that. What? We got it for a minute. Yes, my two A5s are there. So what happened to the others? Did they spawn? Yep, some of them did. And some of them are still being spawned in. Alright, we got them. Last Jangyu. I hope. Yep. So, 2,800 points and 880 lost. Not bad. Not bad for a game where you cannot field any ground-based units, except for units that you either fly in or float in. And the floating in part, for me, was virtually impossible. As for the other guys, this guy was the guy who did the helo rush. And you can see he did pay for that. BB was the guy who was using a lot of artillery and probably ships, but he got a lot of points. He also lost a lot of stuff. I got the most command points of the team. Not surprised there, because I fielded pretty much all of the CVs. As for the enemy team, not seeing... oh, look at that, that's an outlier. 55 rust, that's the last guy surviving. And that's why he has all of those points. As for my lists, let's have a look. Cheetah, look at that thing go. MiG-29 times 2, MiG-25, MiG-23. The AH-64 escort that initially engaged the hilltop, say the top of the volcano, got a lot of kills. VDVs, BMD-3s, more VDVs, Motostrelkis. This guy did a really good job. Another Apache escort, VDV-90s, Motostrelkis, and a ton of transports. F-16 got one yak, and that's I think when he died. You killed three ships. Marine Corps killed a Tunguska and Akatsia? Okay. Must be one of those things that I killed somewhere down the hill. T-80B killed. Spetsnaz Gru group killed. As for the others, Strelas, Akatsias, Spetsnaz. Not too bad. Losses, mostly. Yeah, most of my losses were aircraft. Two do a Tarantul. Two to Sovereign Menis. That's the same Sovereign Meni, actually, and this is the same Tarantul. And one due to a Marine Corps... sorry, that's a Marine Corps group. Yeah, not bad. Not bad. So, very, very weird map. Very, very weird gameplay at that. But I hope you enjoyed, because it's something different. And that's something that I usually enjoy, because Wargame, after so many hours, tends to become a little bit dull. At some point, you've just seen it all, you've done it all, you've had all the possible combinations. And using something like this, where you don't have too many options, where you just have to be smart about your deployment, I really enjoy that. It's something new. So let me know what your thoughts are on that map in the comments. Have you had good experiences with them? Terrible? Do you hate it? Do you love it? Let me know. Looking forward to seeing your thoughts down below in the comments. And as per the usual, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll be seeing you soon for the next video.